radio station around. iLife Radio, the new social network.
Hey, this is Emily King, and you're listening to iLife Radio.
Hello there, this is Benjamin Clementine, and listen to iloveradio.com.
This is Dwight Drummond from CBC News Toronto, and you're listening to iLife Radio.
Online and on the go on your mobile phone. We're the internet's best choice.
This is DJ Amber from Rap Salute, extraordinarily good hip-hop on iLive Radio. You can catch my show every Friday night on iLive Radio from 10 p.m. to midnight Eastern Time with my co-host Q from the Dream Warriors. Rap Salute, sponsored by the hip-hop magazine, repping the lifestyle, the culture, the music, and the DJs.
This is John Brasky. If I'm not snapping necks, cashing checks, wearing the large specs, I'm tuned into iLive Radio.
You're listening to iLive Radio, changing the way you listen to radio. iLive Radio.
Women now upon Eglinton. I'm in Nottin Scarborough. Me, I listen to iLive Radio. Seeing.
Yo, you better salute because it is Rap Salute. You hear me? John Bronski right here, iLive Radio. Yo, you better salute because it is Rap Salute. You hear me? John Bronski right here, iLive Radio.
Good evening, welcome to Rap Salute. DJ Sessions filling in for DJ Amber and Q, who are both away at the moment, one in Calgary, the other in Trinidad. Shouts out to Q. Bring back my punching. Be a problem if you don't. So we have a very special guest inside of the studio. So how do you pronounce your name? Is it Lucia D or Lucia D?
Lucia. It's Lucia. Like St. Lucia where I'm from.
Okay, you have to get you closer to the microphone. You want to pull it towards you a bit or come a bit closer. Close. There you go. So it's Lucia.
Lucia.
Yeah. Now, the reason why I said that is because Omar's manager's the same name. Oh. I call her Lucia and she said, no, it's Lucia.
Italian.
Yeah, she's Italian.
Yes.
Yeah. That's how it goes. Anyway, so you're tuned into Rap Salute. We're doing a top five today. We're going to have a debate. We've got Spec One coming to the studio. Oh, no, he should be on his way right now. I want to give him a quick shout. Going to come in for an interview. iLive Radio is sponsoring, or one of the sponsors, on the Spec One South Africa tour, which starts on the 21st of June. So he's heading off to the UK for a couple of days, and then he's heading out to South Africa. Hooked him up with some interviews and a couple of performances out there. Massive shouts out to Morris from Colourful Radio. Hooked him up today with an interview on Colourful over the Skype. He'll also be interviewing Owen Mysol. So when Spec One gets in, we're going to get into this debate, talk about what he's going to be doing over the next few months and the new material that he's going to be sharing with everybody. So, set a challenge today. Lucia.
So hard.
It's not hard.
It's so hard. It's so hard. Five is difficult.
Five is difficult?
Very difficult.
I don't know.
I found it challenging because, as I was telling you, like, when I think about my high school days in hip-hop, I could choose five then. Then I think about when I got more rebellious as I got older, I could have five then. Then when I got more conscious and it, you know, my backpack came on, five more then. So five was next to impossible. It was hard.
Hold on, did you say backpack days?
Yes.
Or the days of like Delta Funky Homo Sapien and
exactly.
Hieroglyphics
exactly right.
Crew. Okay.
Exactly.
All right, cool. So we're going to play some joints tonight. I'm going to play a few just to warm it up, and then we're going to get into our top five debates. So I'm going to ask you right now, without thinking, top five rappers of all time, excluding Rakim. You can't use Rakim.
Black Thought. AZ. MF Doom.
Okay.
I gotta say Pac because I'm a... Don't roll your eyes. Okay. Don't roll your eyes.
Go ahead.
And I think for me, maybe Talib.
That's interesting.
Yeah.
They're all from a certain era with the exception of Pac, who's just slightly
right.
Outside that era.
Right.
That's very interesting when you say the top five of all time. I would expect a KRS-One in there or...
That's true. You see, and this is the difficulty. Five is hard, right? Because there's KRS, there's Nas, Pharrell. I mean, it goes on and Big L, Pun. How can you strangle me with five?
Well, I did say top five. In no particular order, but I did say top five.
Still hard.
All right. So what we're going to do, we're going to get some music and then we're going to get back to our discussion on the Rapsalute takeover, DJ Sessions and Lucia inside of the studio. See, I called you Lucia again. I know.
Coming from the urban city ghettos, but we still king, queen, natural born rebels. Black tails, crack cells, heavy bolus pebbles. We done push it along. We done seen everything from niggas gunfights, selling dope, getting cream. It ain't depression, you can ask my ancestors. Trifecta from the Tribeca. I bet you we'll push it along. Resurrect low effort. Lil 17 trying to microphone check it. Niggas trying to stress it. Rather see me Pyrex it. That ain't me, that ain't we the essence.
Push it along. Push it along.
Okay.
Push it along. Just push it along. Come on.
It's too much to spit. My life is kinda tragic. I'd rather spit a hit for the gym and be Kobe. Still on the quest like Fife and Jerobe. Gotta
push it along.
Just tired of being bombed out.
Yeah, it's been a minute, nothing short of 60 seconds. Can't stomach where I come from, hard to eat breakfast. You ain't refined when you're trying to get acceptance. Golexes, Rolexes, stupid dumb necklace.
You see the rap game is stitched in my hoodie. Like when I'm on a mic to excite you like I'm goody. Mob never slog, you guess this, what is this? Bit with a dip when I kick this relentless. Yeah,
you did it to death, but that's a death wish. Gotta do it big like you precious. Let's just
push it along. Push it along.
Okay.
Push it along, just push it along.
Come on, push it.
Yeah, you gotta pull it. Yeah, you gotta do what you do and keep it moving. Yeah, you gotta push it. Yeah, you gotta pull it. Yeah, you gotta do what you do and keep it moving. Yes, you gotta push it. Yeah, you gotta pull it. Yeah, you gotta do what you do and keep it moving. Yeah, yeah, you gotta.
Just fuck the name, say Young Trey got his cream on. Block got embraced, but his haste, the love born. About to move up a Jefferson theme song. The memes I stream, but what he gon' lean
down
on?
Juice top shotter, who claim hotter? Trash rhymes back off, your mic's getting cut off. New York to Rock City, yeah. We never rhyme soft, emphasizing true spit. That girth,
yeah. Rose gold dreams, high self-esteem. Living on your knees, ain't the grease overseas. Clock don't stop, so the crock I steam. Don't close shop, trying to cop heavy triple beams.
You better push it along, like tribes instinctive gravel. Hey, hey, hey. Man, we know the voice, what he ranks back in the south. Say, well, despite hiatus, I stay as ready to battle.
Hey, hey.
Salute, because it is rap salute. You hear me? John Bronski right here, I Love Radio.
Strong, and here we go. Cause it's the B, the R, the O, the O, K. L, Y, N is the place where I
rugged skill that's often and land your fucking asses in the coffin. What? You see cold steel, cause niggas want a meal like Shaquille O'Neal. Bullets are real, cock it back and then I peel off. Fuck the kamikaze mechas on a shoddy hottie. The cops are running white chalk around your dead body. Abandoned ship, niggas are ready to flip and back a punk they can't fight next night. Twist the lism by your grave site.
Over, yes, you're over 6 feet under your sleep. I'm out of ease, you're deceased. A reason for the trees and hunting season, not for rabbit or deer. For niggas drinking beers, lounging on block till the early morn. Word is born, another brother gone. Caught up in bullshit, quit talking with knives and banana clips. Familiar with bloodshed, the color red, dude in the fucking head. Man, you're dead, death becomes you.
Yeah, I'm from the Vernonville. Pack shots. Infrared's locked on your heads, here come the feds, freeze. Now when I squeeze hot metal breeze right through your arteries to bring you to your knees, I think he's dying black. I got the track to send your silly ass niggas back. Snatch your hoe, stab your pimp and watch him limp away. I fiend Luigi till I'm fucked up, old and gray. Hey dog, I send you to the morgue, I'm from the Vernonville. Blood spill, shows dropping.
When you heard it go pop, pop, my Glock, hit that nigga's nut, cause I'm one of the hot ops. Smoking motherfuckers like crack rocks. So back up, he goes, when I kick my toe. Murder, she wrote, yo, fully equipped with the death blow. Flipping, because I'm on the level like a rebel. Crazy bodies and tombstones, straight to the devil. Nigga, laying your best friend, because you're through from evil that men do. Shifty nigga, death becomes you.
You're tuned into Rapsalute, top five. Just coming out of Pete Rock's Death to Come to You. Into Gangstar. See, I was surprised you didn't say Guru as well. What's going on?
I was just thinking that.
You were just thinking Guru, right? Okay. So let's talk about your ever-changing top five. So what happened was, Lucia, Saint Lucia, she sent in her top five tracks to me. So I go get the top five tracks. And then she comes into the studio with 5 minutes ago and goes, I've changed my top five.
Yes.
Okay, so.
And it could still be changing as I sit here, to be honest.
Get the hell out of here.
I'm telling you, it's impossible. It's impossible.
No way.
I'm sitting here flipping through my music.
Okay.
And I'm, there's no way.
Okay.
It's really, I mean, the age that I am now, the years that I've been listening to hip hop, I mean, it's just the stories that you can tell, the songs, the artists, it's fast. So it's hard.
Okay. Okay. So, all right. So let's hit your top five. Let's pick one. Pick the first one. No particular order.
No particular order.
No particular order.
I'll start with Master Ace. He's one of my definite favorites.
Okay.
For sure.
Okay. Master Ace. Why? Why Master Ace?
Honestly, the flow, the feel of the music, I feel very, he's grassroots, you know what I mean? He has that feel from back in the day, like the J-Ru days and fundamental hip-hop feel is what I like about him.
Yeah, yeah. Master Ace, I have to say, is in my top 10 of all time.
Absolutely.
Of all time.
Absolutely.
Vastly underrated MC.
Yes.
Doesn't get the props he should.
That's very true.
Doesn't get
very
props
underrated.
He should. Okay, so what's the track you picked for your one?
Beautiful.
Beautiful?
Yes.
Okay, so you're going to pick a Master Ace track, and I'm going to pick a Master Ace track. How's that sound?
That's a bet.
Because in my top five, I have a Master Ace track.
Okay.
Yeah? All right, so this is Rapsalute. We're going to get to Master Ace right now in discussion with Lucia right here, iLive Radio.
Down. Queens, beautiful. Shout locked away, but not today. I have to laugh on the real, I have to mask kinda ill like I'm Dr. Dre. Sometimes I run to the club and get faded. This game make you get jaded, I just hate it. But this song is a different kind of feeling. It's a new kind of dealing, it's a special kind of healing. And I can show what it is. Best flow in the biz, you know what it is. Positive over negative, see the ace of master. Even when I face disaster, I rise up above. See people still showing me love. Got the respect without dropping a check. This hip hop thing might stop in a sec. So this brand new hit, you can pop in the deck. It's beautiful.
So look inside yourself. Something you never felt. Feeling like nothing else. What's inside goes beyond your mind.
It's beautiful.
So look inside yourself. Something you never felt. Feeling like nothing else. What's inside goes beyond your eyes.
This is brand new uptown, still in a box. This the Yankees, 10-0, killing the Sox. This ain't hugging the block with a gat in your hand. This is Boca Raton on a catamaran. With the sun beaming down where you at in the sand. I feel like I'm more than a cat with a plan. This feels like it's more than a flash in the pan. This is milk in a cup and cash in your hand. This is a warm coat on the coldest night. That's why I stole this mic, y'all don't hold this right.
Nope.
First in the class of many. This is a bottle of Jack, no, a glass of Henny. And I drink it up till there ain't nothing left in it. I'm reppin' it, BK, that's a definite. Just more of these amazing rhymes. A song like this in these days and times is beautiful.
So look inside yourself. Something you never felt.
Don't forget you can watch us on YouTube, we're streaming live. Simply go to the YouTube channel for iLive Radio. Look inside the studio. Spec One is on his way.
Feeling like nothing else.
Got a bit lost on his way here.
The most beautifulest thing ever, and it's here to bring terror to the bling era. You can feel it in your inner, it's like grandma's house, Thanksgiving dinner. It's like a day in the park, or at night when you get the ball and you play in the dark. It's that street corner music where most cats, when they pull that heat, go and use it. I see a black man aiming his gun, but I'd rather see a black man claiming his son. You know the sound is pretty. Even when you gotta get down and gritty. This is money in the bank like you down with Diddy. This a helicopter ride around the city. And we love it cause it brought us here. This a young mother great and a do. Young mother great and a do. Young mother great and a do. Young mother great and a do.
At 8 you're a sucker, at 7 a motherfucker. At 8 you're a sucker, at 7 a motherfucker. At 8 you're a sucker, at 7 a motherfucker. At 8 you're a sucker, at 7 a motherfucker. At 8 you're a sucker, at 7 a motherfucker. At 8 you're a sucker, at 7
my favorite Master Ace track.
You're a sucker, at 7 a motherfucker. At 8 you're a sucker, at 7 a motherfucker.
10 9 8 7 6 5 4 3 2 1 reasons you'll never be this raw. Who's representing for BK? Don't play, or you might have to get Crime Watch around your way. Cause Brooklyn keep on taking it, still from way back. Say black, trying to get their fortune like Say Jack. There must be at least 20 reasons you can't win in this rap game. You're hopeless. Here's the top 10. 10's very simple and plain as petty crime. It was only 94 when you wrote your first rhyme. And now you think you got more skill and power tools. But never could your feet fit up in our shoes. You only got one delivery. One dimensional rappers is dead as chivalry. Don't get your spot blown up. Block sewn up. I lift MCs to tone up. Rip your zone up. I got more flavors than women's dush. Make ends with Mexicans and rock dreads and flat bush. Nah, you can't see mine. Can't find mine. Can't do mine. Step to mine. Where my crew find? A frontin' ass nigga, we get in his. You don't wanna get beaten, box like Biz. You ain't wild cause you run with wild kids. Now the chorus gonna tell you what 8 and 7 is. Check it.
At 8 you're a sucker, at 7 a motherfucker. At 8 you're a sucker, at 7 a motherfucker. At 8 you're a sucker, at 7 a motherfucker. At 8 you're a sucker, at 7 a motherfucker.
6, I bury that ass like Holly. All up on tracks like a trolley, my golly, like Bob Marley. We jamming by all means, and real gangsters don't talk shit in magazines. 5, never judge a rapper by the song he make. Some of the coolest rapping niggas will drop your ass in the lake. And on the other hand, some of them screaming keep it real. Their video's the only time they ever bust a steal. 4, you don't faze me, this ain't Star Trek. I know where you park your cars at, as far as that beef that's going on in all these spots and parking lots, niggas pop more shit than shots. Funny, dummy, lyrics don't stun me. If I was your only pair of pants, you still couldn't run me. Out this rap game, this INC for life. Niggas gon' know soon, cause Brownsville's strife. All up in the mix like blenders, offenders, life enders, whatever genders, never surrenders. Coming at you, gonna catch you, and when we find you, don't lose count, let me be mine.
So that was the first of Lucia's selections. So Master Ace.
That's a good start.
I'll give you that one.
Yeah, that's a good start.
That one, I'll mark one on the board for you for that one.
Thank you.
All right.
Yes.
Number two on your changed list.
Number two on my, well, this was on my original list.
Okay,
as well.
Original list. Okay.
So Big L.
Big L.
And Put It On.
Put It On?
Yeah.
Okay.
Big time in hip hop. Honestly speaking, if you think about what he would have done had he not passed away, he would have made some crazy tunes, the careers he would have launched. So Big L definitely short-lived, underrated, I think, as well sometimes.
Yeah, he was a lyrical god.
Yeah,
he
ridiculous.
Really was. He's
absolutely
ridiculous.
Nuts.
Absolutely
nuts.
We welcome Spec One into the studio.
Welcome. Yo, yo.
What's going on, my friend?
Yeah. What are you guys saying?
We are debating right now. Oh, top fives.
Straight to it. Yeah. Okay, that depends. What's the exact specific top five category?
Well, you know, we're kind of going through it. I mean, she gave me a top five of her top five tracks, but we're going to talk about top five of everything. Okay, I'm going to ask you right now.
Okay.
Top five MCs of all time, excluding Rakim. You have to take Rakim out of the picture.
Man. That's extremely difficult because of the whole concept of era.
Thank you.
You got your eras.
That's right.
But you have those gems that stand out in that era.
In every era.
And
yeah,
then,
you're right.
Then you have to take one of those and say, all right, that's what represents that era. How's that?
You're right.
It's a hard thing.
Okay. If I'm to go all the way back, I'd have to say Melly Mel.
Ooh.
Okay.
Because he was the first to actually start telling stories with it.
Yep.
Feel me?
Yeah.
Well, not the first. There's Grandmaster Caz.
Yeah.
He told stories, but I mean, Melly Mel told street stories.
That's right.
I mean? And that changed a lot. I gotta give it to KRS because that was of its time the biggest hip hop clash between him and Shan, and it made each team stronger.
Yeah, definitely.
And people feel like because KRS is still thriving right now and MC Shan is not making as much noise that, I mean, KRS whopped MC Shan. But nah, if you listen to the actual battle, they went head to head. Like,
for a minute.
Yeah, man.
For a minute. I know. Well, I mean, that's my era I grew up in, right? So, you know, I'm of that age where that whole battle went down. And yeah, you know, Shan was the only guy represented from the Juice Crew, by the way.
Yes.
Everybody else backed
Everyone
out.
Everyone just kept their mouth
Everyone
quiet as kept.
And he took on the whole of BDP crew.
Exactly.
On his own. Give him respect for that. Yeah. But, you know, when he did The Bridges Over, it was done. Sorry. That song just...
Finished it.
Finished it.
That was it.
Okay.
Who else do I got to put it there? I got to put Nas up there.
Yeah.
Nas, okay.
Nas definitely changed a lot.
Okay.
Where are we at so far? Three, right?
That's three.
That's three.
All right, I'm trying to come down through the eras.
The eras, right.
You know? Man. I got to give it to Big.
Okay.
Right? And let me show you how commercial and how much of a staple Biggie Smalls is in pop culture. That during that era when he came out, that bracket between like 93 and 95, mm-hmm. there was so much hip-hop going on that you didn't even have to listen to like Big, because there was like you had Snoop, you had Pac, you had Nas, you had Jay, you had Outkast, you had Doggy Style. Like, classics were coming out at that era, so I wasn't even listening to Biggie around that time.
Yeah,
but his music was so pop culture and so successful that even though I wasn't a Biggie fan, I still knew every Biggie lyric.
That's right,
because you'd hear it everywhere.
Yes,
so the impact that he had, that's undeniable.
Okay,
so he's got to be on that list.
Go one more, my friend.
One more.
Jeez. One more.
It's a difficult one.
I
Five is always the hardest one.
I know, right?
Exactly. You feel me?
Exactly.
Because when you get to five, it's like, shoot, this for that for this. Man. I think I have to give it to Pac.
Ah.
I think
Thank
I have
you.
To give it to Pac.
See that?
Wiley.
I'll have to give it to Pac, man.
See that? Okay. Well, why not? Why not Pac?
People that were born after his death know who Pac is.
That's true. That's like, true. Pac is... Okay, we'll get into the discussion of me and Pac don't have like a great oral relationship.
What did he do to you?
Nothing personally.
And who he was in real life.
Yeah,
you know what I mean?
You know, with me, Pac was a bit of a contradiction. And I guess that's where his strength and his power came from, because he was... You know, talking subconscious stuff on one side and thug life on his stomach on the other. I understand
Absolutely.
He was opposing things that used to go on within him, but
he was at war.
I think that was a journey that he went through to get there, right?
Yeah.
He didn't start that way.
Oh no, he didn't. You know how he started?
He was with digital underground, and he was the hype guy.
Yeah,
right?
wearing mascot suits and everything.
Yeah, the first time I saw Pac was on stage in London in 1988,
Word.
Doing the Running Man.
Right.
To Humpty Dance.
That's what's up.
That was it.
Because I paid dues.
I don't know. It's there's something about his... I think the lyrics are undeniable. Mm. I think his delivery I didn't like.
Mm.
The way they used to double track his voice. His voice is very thin, right?
So it's an acquired taste.
Yeah. That's what it is. And then when I heard him freestyle live, I was like, ah, okay. Nah, you don't ever do that again.
Damn.
Really?
Yeah. Yeah, don't leave it alone. Leave it for people that can do that stuff. No disrespect to him, but he got outed by Shaheem the Rugged Child, which is not cool.
Wow.
I mean, you do have a point. You know, there's several angles you could come at it with. You know, I mean, you could also factor in who he was and the lineage that he came from.
That's right.
He came from Panthers.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So although he was screaming thug life, he definitely did put certain jewels in it. To me, he's the prime example of the rapper who lived what he spoke.
He spoke, yeah.
Right.
No, I know, don't get me wrong. For all those people that think I'm a Tupac hater, I'm really not. I've got a lot of respect for him and what he did, and the sheer volume of material that he put out and the importance of it. Like, you know, when he did Brenda's Got a Baby, was like, that was like,
exactly.
spoke to all women, right?
Yeah.
So I had to respect him for certain things.
That was the thing about him. I think when the standout songs, those gems that you're talking about, the message within those songs, undeniable, and they're going to transcend time. You can listen to those songs, Brenda's Got a Baby, right now, and still have
Dear
the
Mama.
Same impact. Dear Mama,
yeah.
She has so
still
many
have
tears.
The same impact,
she has so many
right?
tears. Mm-hmm.
Even the angry songs, like when you're pissed off, you throw on a Pac song and you're driving down the street waving your, you know.
Right. And the thing about Big and Pac are that it's like ominous, because they predicted their death through their music. It was like you heard it, and when it happened and you go back and you listen to it, you're like, these guys were really prophets, to the point where they prophesized how their life was going to play out and their death ultimately.
Well, I mean it was a very interesting era. I mean, the whole East Coast West Coast rivalry, it was very, very real. It wasn't on wax or on paper or rumors. It was, you know, these guys were living like anytime you walk into a club it could be done. That's how thick it was then.
Yeah.
And you had media like The Source just stoking the fires constantly with this rivalry, which really wasn't there. I mean, if you listen to watch the documentaries, it really wasn't there between the crews. It was stoked by the media.
Yeah.
Just that it was a time in hip hop when rappers were real. Rappers were real street dudes. Whereas now it's like, you don't have to have street cred to be a street dude to be a rapper. You can just be straight out of college.
That's right.
So it was like you have so many different cliques and crews of real mans that are ready to pop off and defend at any moment. And you got media feeding into all of the beef and the hype.
It's
bound to happen.
Absolutely. We're going to get to Lucia's second selection, which is Big L.
Yes.
Put it on.
Hey yo, you better flee, hops, or clout in my name sprout. Some brothers will still be burnt, just the crack never came out. I got the wild style, always been a foul child. My guns go boom, boom, and your guns go pow, pow. I'm known to have a hottie open, I keep the shoddy smoking. Front and get half the bones in your body broken. And when it comes to getting nookie, I'm not a rookie. I got girls that make that chick Toni Braxton look like Whoopi. I run with sturdy clicks, I'm never hitting dirty chicks. Got 35 bodies, buddy, don't make it 36. Step to this, your good is gone, word is born. I leave mics torn when I put it on. So put it on. Got more cash than Gotti, you don't know? You better ask somebody. Big L is a crazy brother, and I'm a lady lover. A smooth kid that'll run up in your baby mother. I push a slick Benz, I'm known to hit skins and get ends and commit sins with sick friends. Cause I'm a money getter, also a honey hitter. You think you nice as me? Haha, use a funny nigga. I flows, so one of my shows wouldn't be clever to miss. I'm leaving competitors pissed to tell you the truth, it gets no better than this. I'm catching wreck to the break of dawn. In this song, yo, it's a must that I put it on.
Me, it's feeding me the inspiration to rigidly rock the nation from white folk to Haitian.
but equal. Jamaican, burn the seas like degrees of mace. Because you're fake, I'm on point, exclamation with the caper. The flavor misbehavior from the super duper rhyme maker.
Like the phone master, super rhyme maker.
At the show, it's the friends, foes, thinking these stunts and hoes, drats, I'm thinking they're rather fat. Oh shit, my crew is shake, rattle, and roll thick, thicker than your butt, cause yo, I be's a Brooklyn trooper, and I got more spunk than that punk from Punky Brewster. But the lingo, gringo, thinking these star, bingo, I run shit like Kunta, break bones like Mandingo, I'm starstruck like Starbuck, the bad bro with Mad, I'm all that, more cat like Tonka, or Hasbro, I have to. Yeah, it's me and Wise, masters of the microphone, makers of the
show. Well, yo, this shit sound clever. I'm down for whatever, like nothing nice. Pick up to DJ Dice, record shop when he cut and slice. These corny MCs, please, I never heard of some. We need to murder some like Colin Ferguson. But now you heard us from the under, to feel the thunder. You better come clean like J. Rue or Felix Sucker. I'm brother, like whistle, see I suggest you.
You're tuning to Rapsalute. Hashtag top five. Don't forget we're streaming live on YouTube. Also via the iLive Radio website. And all the mobile devices, Apple or iPhone, should I say. And Google devices. All right, so next on your list.
All right, next on my list, Saint Lucia, is The Roots. Black Thought. The tune is called Water. And absolutely, I think Black Thought has to be recognized as one of the top lyricists out there. Not only is it, he's lyrically ridiculous, he flows on a beat like a jockey. He can actually really freestyle. Yeah, he can freestyle. It's raw. And the musicality behind what he's doing, it takes it to another level. So Black Thought for me is hands down one of the top of top.
Yeah, I ain't gonna lie. Black Thought is a beast.
Top of top.
He's a beast.
And.
Oh, there's more?
And. Seeing them live, him, all of them, The Roots, it's mind-blowing. Mind-blowing. Yeah. Like, that's a show. That's what you want to go pay your money and go see music right in front of you. That's what it is. Love it.
No, I agree. The first experience I had with Black Thought was in London, actually. I used to go to a club on a Tuesday night, a place called The Borderline. And it used to be a hip-hop night. And at the time, The Roots were living in London, being a gigging band around an era called Camden.
Ah.
So they used to come down to this hip-hop night. It was a freestyle night. That's the first time I saw Black Thought. This is like 93, maybe.
Wow.
92, 93. All those years ago. And I remember seeing Amir, big afro, walking in the London Underground. I was like, the hell is that? Turned up at the same club he was DJing and he was freestyling. It was cool, man. But that's a beast. That's a beast.
Yeah, ridiculous.
That's a beast of an agency. What about yourself, Spec? What do you think of Black Thought?
Black Thought definitely is up there with those distinct voices that resonate from that era and have managed to sustain a career all the way to now. Like, the kids know him because he's on Jimmy Fallon.
Right.
Yeah.
That is an amazing feat to come from that era and still be relevant. And I think a huge part of that goes to the fact that, as you said, their live show is amazing.
Yeah.
You know, as long as you have that good, solid live show, your fans will follow you throughout the years.
I think their live show sets a standard
for
hip-hoppers, to be honest. I don't think you can get better than The Roots live. Like, you really can't.
Nothing like it.
Yeah.
And even if you see them repeatedly, each time, you'll hear the same song and it'll be done differently, a different arrangement, a different feel in each show. They're phenomenal.
That's actually a dope top five best live performers.
Yes.
That's a dope top five.
Okay. All right, so... before we get into Roots Water, we'll talk about other top fives off the thing. So, top five groups.
Oh, jeez.
Off the top of your head, right now. Okay, you know what? I'll make it easy. Top three groups.
Top three.
No, we need you five. Make it
easy. You need five? You want five? You want five?
Okay.
Top three Tribe groups. Girl Quest. Definitely Tribe.
Tribe, okay.
Woo.
Absolutely.
Woo, yeah.
What do we consider as groups? Like two or more than two?
Two or more.
Outkast.
Yes. That's here as well.
That's here as well.
Yeah.
He lives in my lap, right?
Yeah.
He's living in my lap.
See, I did say three, right? You guys
you
got stuck.
Three.
So you got Woo. You have
Public
Outkast.
Public Enemy.
Public Enemy.
Thank you.
Yes.
Public Enemy.
Thank you. How can you forget Public Enemy?
N.W.A.
Yes.
Yes.
And N.W.A.
N.W.A.
That's an interesting. That's an interesting choice. Why N.W.A.?
N.W.A. because they are the foundation, and their lineage is still living right now and is as strong as it is.
Yeah.
So much came from that one group. So much. Like, we can go on. That's like, that'll take a long time for us to go on and see, like, who came from Q, who came from Dre, who came from Eazy-E.
Yeah.
You know?
Okay. Well, I guess in terms of influence, yeah. Influence. They are top five. You know, I can't fault that top five. Okay, so I'm going to ask you just one.
I'm going to ask, what do you have against West Coast rappers?
I don't have nothing against West Coast rappers.
Far Side.
Let's see. Far I was about side. To ask, in terms of groups that don't get recognized as much, who do you say? Who's your top group that doesn't really didn't get the recognition they deserved based on the kind of music that they did? Oh, she's got the list right there.
She got notes.
I don't actually have groups, though. But I have individuals.
I know. Well, no groups. I say groups.
Damn you.
Das Effects. Absolutely.
Yeah, they changed the game.
They changed the game, and people don't understand because everyone changed the way that they rapped around that time when they came out.
Yes, they did.
Yeah.
And they just took little elements of that triple rap.
Yeah.
You understand what I'm saying? But okay. Das Effects.
Das Effects. Okay, I hear that.
I think Leaders of the New School.
The New School. Yes.
Yeah, definitely.
Yes. See, I'm going to show my age right now.
Yeah.
My one is Ultra Magnetic MCs.
Wow.
Okay.
They changed everything.
For real.
They changed everything. Production, delivery, Ultra was like my ultimate group that never really got the props that it deserved. All right. So without further ado, we're going to get into some Roots and Water. St. Lucia's third pick.
Yes.
South Philly, North Side, Oakland, Texas, Georgia, black people. Yeah. Worldwide, it's for my nigga. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Dumb and blind. They say a record ain't nothing if it's not touching, gripping. Draw you in closer, make you wanna listen to it. And if you real ill at making music, the listener feel like he living through it. That's how my nigga do it. I met Slacks back in like 91 rapping. We went to Millersville to get away from gun clapping. It ain't last, I be in class dreaming about 50,000 fans up in the stands screaming out encore. Yo, I'm headed back to Philly. Nigga, you rolling with me? I'm trying to get busy. We walked dogs that was off the chain. A lot of times at the shows, people hardly came. I just took it and stride as part of the game. But inside, people down with me started to change. It was a couple things. Low serum, low pills. Instead of routing out on the road, you rather chill. I know the way the pleasure feels. I'm not judging, but still I'm on a mission. Yo, I'm not bugging. I got fam that can't stop drugging. They can't sleep. They can't stick to one subject. They can't eat. It's people steady coming at me out in the street. Like Greek, yo, what up with your pizza? It gets deep, nigga. Yo, you need to walk straight, master your high. Son, you missing out on what's passing you by. I done seen the streets suck a lot of cash dry. But not you and I, my nigga. We got to get, come on, over the water. Come on, over the water. Jump the water, water. Yo, we done been through many meals, a couple of deals. We done shared clothes and wheels, killed mics and reels. We done rocked shows abroad and slept on floors, trying to figure what the fuck we getting slept on for, or what we walking with the weapon for. Waiting by the gravity law. You know it if you came up poor, my nigga. Picture the bus up north. You know we made her, everything out. Laws are made her. I'm far from a hater, and I don't say I love you, cause the way I feel is greater. And Miller, you a poet, son, you a born creator. And it's a probably dawn on you later. It's in your nature.
beats and lyrics all on your walls like they made of paper. You got to follow where your talent take you. You might fuck around, finally make it, and that's real. But
yo, you need to walk straight, master your high. So you missing out on what's passing you by. I done seen the streets suck a lot of gas dry, but not you and I, my nigga. We got to get yo over, over the water. Yo, over, over the water. Yo, water.
All to understand, I come from South Philly. And when I walk the street, it's like a pharmacy. They got all type of shit anybody could get. And go from H to X to Lucy. Cigarette for my ghetto legend, known for little shites running. Cop codeine by the courts and keep coming. Dumbing, just embracing the dope like it's a woman. You burn the both sides of the rope and just pulling, tugging. In between Islam and straight thugging. Laying every day around the way and doing nothing. See them looking, shaking their head and start shrugging. If they don't got a man like mine, they got a cousin. Hey yo, you better be a true friend to him before the shit put an end to him, or give a pen to him, or lock him in the studio with a mic, cause on a rail it might save his life. Keep telling him,
yo, you need to walk straight, master your high. So you missing out on what's passing you by. I done seen the streets suck a lot of cash dry, but not you and I, my nigga. We got to get, come on, over, over the water. Come on, over, over the water. Come on.
So that was The Roots and Water. Pretty hot track.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, pretty hot track, I ain't gonna lie.
Yeah, 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 yeah.
All right, so what we got next, St. Lucia?
Next. Big Daddy Kane.
Big Daddy Kane. Now see, I'm waiting for someone to bring him up.
I'm gonna reach back.
You're gonna reach right back. All right,
Daddy Kane. And I wanna hear Raw.
You wanna hear Raw?
Yes.
Raw.
Classic.
Well, you know, Kane is, to me, is the supreme lyricist.
Oh.
Yeah. He is.
The like, king, Asiatic, no one's equal.
There you go.
And you know what's beautiful? Is he still dances.
You feel me?
Still dances like he used to.
Well, he used to do that. He used to dance and rap.
Oh, yes.
It was ridiculous.
Wonderful.
Right.
He'll drop bars. He'll drop a 16 and then...
And then break out. It down. Yeah.
And then back into another 16.
You
and
feel me?
Like, without...
Sick. He was out here about a year or two ago.
Yeah.
I think it was last year, maybe. And that show was electric. Mm. Electric. When he started to jam that place, the roof was like on fire. Crazy.
Okay, so you consider Raw your favorite Big Daddy Kane track?
That's the one that I would lose my marbles to, yeah.
Same here.
Yeah.
Raw.
I'd lose my marbles to that one.
That's interesting, because in the UK, Raw was big, but Set It Off was our track.
That's a huge song,
yeah,
too.
That was our, we used to lose our damn minds to that track, man. Oh, Running Man and whopping and
that's exactly what I'm thinking of.
Crazy
how hard,
stuff, man.
A lot of arms and, yeah, man, that's, those are the
times. You know, I miss that era of the up tempo hip hop.
Yep.
You know, the 105, 106, 110 beats a minute hip hop.
That was my introduction to hip hop. The first hip hop song I ever heard, Kool Moe Dee, How You Like Me Now.
How You Like Me Now.
Wow, that was my first concert ever.
Yeah.
Kool Moe Dee, yes.
See, I Kool Moe Dee, love him. And he was the very first lyrical MC for me.
Mm-hmm. When you were an LL man, is what you're saying.
Well, LL bodied him in Break of Dawn, right? He bodied him in Break of Dawn. It was done.
I mean, I wouldn't say bodied.
Nah, he bodied him. He bodied him. Man.
You know what it was? It's okay.
Yeah, he did. Yeah.
LL definitely won. He definitely won the battle.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? But in the beginning, it wasn't looking good for LL when the How You Like Me Now came out.
Oh, I know.
But LL definitely did survive that and persevere.
And that's the interesting thing is when LL dropped that track, he didn't even put it on an album. He put it on a house party soundtrack.
That's true.
And I could never work out why. And then I watching an interview, and he said the reason why he did that is because he knew House Party was going to be a huge hit,
mm-hmm.
and the distribution on that track was going to be massive.
Chess moves,
smart.
So it was a chess move.
Yeah.
He goes, you know what? I went for him, I went for Hammer, and I went for Ice-T.
Everybody.
Just in one shot.
That's
Yeah, I don't think there's anybody else that's taken out three MCs in one record.
Nah.
Nas.
Nas did.
The bridge is over. You went at Prodigy, Core Omega, and Nature, and a little bit of Jay.
Went at them, but did he take them?
I mean, nobody, he talked about nobody responded.
That's true.
There's that's also true. Cube.
Yep.
Cube had his No Vaseline record.
Yeah, well, yeah. Yeah, that's true. That's true. All right, so we're going to get into some Big Daddy Kane, going back into the days, Prism label. This is Raw.
Terrorist, here to bring trouble to phony MCs. I move on and seize, I just conquer and solve another rapper with ease. Cause I'm at my apex and others are below. Nothing but a milliliter, I'm a kilo, second to none. Making MCs run, so don't try to step to me, cause I ain't the one. I believe rappers just like Tylenol, and they know it. So I don't see why you all try to front, perpetrating a stunt, when you know that I smoke you up like a blunt. I'm genuine like Gucci, raw like sushi. This age of rage is what rap did to me, to make me wanna create chaos and mayhem. Cold rock a party until the AM, I'll make a muscle, grab the mic and hustle. While you stand dazed and amazed, I'll bust a little rhyme with authority, superiority, and captivate the whole crowd's majority. The rhymes I use definitely amuse, better than Dynasty or Hill Street Blues. I'm sure to score and door for more without a floor, cause I get raw. Rappers are severing, and in my lifetime, believe I've never been beaten or eaten and just tooken out. You know, come to think about it, I keep them seats looking out and real nervous when I'm at your service. So give me that title, boy, you don't deserve this. I work like a slave to become a master, and when I say a rhyme, you know that it has to be perfectly fitted, cause I'm committed, the entertainer and trainer and Kane are getting with it. I go and flow and grow to let you know I damage you. I'm not an amateur, but a professional, unquestionable, without doubt, superb. So full of action, my name should be a verb. My voice will float on every note when I clear my throat. That's all she wrote. The minute that the cane starts to go on, believe it's gonna be smooth sailing, so on. As I put other rappers out of their misery, get them in a battle and make them all history. Ruling and schooling, and sees that I'm dueling. Watch them all take a fall as I sit back cooling on my throne with the bronze microphone. God bless the child that can hold his own, cause I can roar.
Ain't it good, kid? Ain't it good, kid?
Step chillin', killin' like a villain. The meaning of raw is ready and willing to do whatever is clever. Take a loss, never. And the rhymes I bust, coming off as a must. And I come off hard with rhymes that are odd. I rip the microphone and leave it scarred. Never smoking or hitting or taking a sniff. Only crushing MCs that be trying to drift. I get strong and titanic, do work like a mechanic. Make MCs panic, they all get frantic and skeptic. Like a girl on a contraceptive as I rock. But hey, what you expected? I'll get raw for you just like a warrior, rather like a samurai. And I'll be damned if I ever let a Fisher Price MC hang. The rhymes a toy, nothing but yin yang. Do it without it on the microphone. Bring your own casket in tombstone, and I'ma preach your funeral. Tell me who in the world could ever come with more. I get more.
Eating shrimp
fashion with a flashy type of fashion. And on stage I get courageous, and I enslave the bravest. More diamonds than Sammy Davis. I'm more dramatic than Dallas is. More pretty than a palaces. Hands no calluses. Give me a clever girl and now I'll fox her. The man that rocks here in pure silk boxes. So what you want, honey? A chump or a champ? V's are food stamps, Latins are lamps. I run a game like Sega. Go to war like Noriega. Hit like Schwarzenegger. Excitement when I'm fighting, I'm frightening. Stick chicks licking quick like grease lightning. Ladies, I love you all tomorrow like Annie. And I bet you all leave with wet panties. Cause I can make an 80 on dash. Come back fast. Rap rappers are left in the back like a jackass. Police wanna harass me. Cause I got all the material that has me looking jazzy. The MC patroller. Pocket so fat, I flat him down with a dough roller. Dead zone when I strike the microphone. G-Rap's known cause I'm bad to the bone.
See, the mics are on now, you know, you're gonna hear your own conversation. You're tuning to Rapsalute right now, Spec One, hey, and St. Lucia in the building.
Yes, yes.
So, we did Big Daddy Kane. We threw on some Cool G Rap as well, because once again, another rapper from that era that doesn't quite get the shine, but he's a bit raw.
Yeah,
absolutely. Know, man, but Road to Riches.
Yeah, Road to Riches, Hill Street Blues,
mm-hmm.
All that stuff, man.
DJ Polo.
All right, so, St. Lucia.
Yes.
What do we have next on your list? What did you choose?
My fifth on the list, although I could have chose many, it's Biggie. I got to do Biggie, unbelievable.
Great choice.
Premier production.
Absolutely.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. Absolutely. So, when's the first time you guys heard Biggie? First track.
My first track was Unbelievable.
Unbelievable.
That was the first time I heard Biggie, and I was in New York. I was in the Bronx. And as I was telling her off air, that the three songs that they were bumping on the radio over and over again were Unbelievable by Biggie, Fuji Loud by Fugees, and Aaliyah back, forth, and forth.
Yeah.
So that was staple for that summer for me.
Right.
Yeah, man.
I would have to say that's the first for me as well.
Yeah.
Unbelievable. Yeah. And it would definitely be a New York attachment. Driving back and forth with family, because I was in school in the States back
yeah.
then. But yeah, definitely New York connection, and that song you can listen to it a million times, and it's like you heard it the first time, right?
Lyrically.
Oh yeah, yeah. Lyrically, he just
absolutely.
He just did it in.
Yeah.
That whole Ready to Die album, he just did it in.
He was definitely high. He says it in interviews, and if you're someone who partakes. You could definitely understand that, yo. He was definitely high through the writing process because he just flowed.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Complete vibe the whole way through.
Yeah, that's true. But my first exposure to Biggie was called the Who's the Man soundtrack, being a DJ, with their Party and Bullshit.
Party and Bullshit,
that's what I heard. But then, you know, I was like, oh, he's okay. He's all right. He's nice, but, like, you know, put him aside. Then I was in New York, and they were bumping, the track they were bumping at the time was Who Shot Ya?
Yes.
That track there. Every single car.
That's true.
I
have a story about that song.
Yeah. Like, every single car.
The next time I was ever in New York, I was with a dude by the name of Richenzo. He comes up here to Toronto every now and then. And we were in Soho. And you could hear it from, like, around the corner, blasting, Ready to Die. There's a Bentley, all the windows down. Whipping around the corner, guess who it is? Irv Gotti. And he's got like the meanest screw face on, just listening to Ready to Die, driving down the street.
Wow.
And I'm like, this is New York.
There you go. Well, yeah, well I was in New York, and we went down to Lakewood in New Jersey. Next to Lakewood is a place called Asbury Park. They do not get on at all. Anyone from Lakewood caught in Asbury Park, that was it. We went to see Biggie and Total in Asbury Park, and my friend was from Lakewood. So it was a great concert, lots of fighting, all girls fighting. I don't know why the girls are fighting. So we're outside in the car park, and everyone's bumping Biggie, Who Shot Ya, and then literally it popped off. Literally it popped off.
It's inspirational.
It was like, bam, 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 bam. I was like, is that a, bam, bam, bam. Everyone hit the floor. We had to get out of the car park. My friend jumped in his car, almost ran somebody over. It was crazy.
Wow.
Absolutely crazy night. But Yeah, so the Toys B.I.G. Ready to Die LP, to me, top 10 classic.
Absolutely.
Top 10 classic of all time.
Yeah.
All right, so we're going to get into some Notorious B.I.G. This is Rapsalute. After this one, we're going to play a couple more tracks, and then we're going to get into a short interview with Spec One talking about his upcoming tour to South Africa.
Bless. Hey.
Stuyvesant, the loudest one, representing BK to the fullest. Gats, I pull it. Bastards ducking when Big B bucking. Chicken heads be clucking in my bathroom, fucking. It ain't nothing. They know Big B handling with the Mac in the act or paneling. Bandaging MCs, oxygen, they can't breathe. Mad tricks up the sleeve. Wear boxes so my dick can breathe. Breeze through in the Q45 by my side. Lyrical high, and those that brushes my clutches get put on crutches. Get smoked like touches from the master. Hate to blast ya, but I have to. You see, I smoke a lot. Your life is played out like Farme and them fucking polka dots. Who rock the spot? Biggie, you know how the weed go. Unbelievable.
Because it is rap salute, you hear me? John Bronski right here, I love it. Ghetto,
it's hard to survive. Some have achieved and many brothers try. But I realize which life to choose. I wanna make money, so I gotta pay dues. But there's no rules, and you only have one chance. If you fuck up, kid, you face the circumstance. At night, I used to scream and shout. Living in a ghetto, trying to get the hell out. So I would try as I watch my friends die. But all I could do is sit back and cry. These are feelings I'm expressing through my rhymes. I've been through hard times, so many problems on my mind. I wasn't living rich, and I also wasn't poor. I try to appreciate, but I deserve more. Yeah, Superman, superstar, give me super fat dough, like Pablo Escobar.
Star, feared by bandits, hated by chicks, loved by kids, and never did a bit. Yes, the group on me thick, plus
I don't eat beef. Cause these dizzy ass niggas and chick think shit is sweet. Yo, I work hard and hard, my man breaks it down through the cars. After that, keep it moving. Have no time to be fooling around town. Ain't it all you get down with this hype sound? The things I sing to make the grown man dream and speak saying. Born by yourself, be by yourself. Let my lyrics vibrate and shake the earth. I travel ghetto to ghetto, back streets to street. Dig around all crime with this ill mastermind. Mom Duke used to tell me with these tears in her eyes. Now I'm out on my own, surviving with the time like an African tribe. Little dap will blow your mind. Check it out like this,
and then like that.
Superstar.
What the fuck y'all moving on up? Get the group on with this. So hold your pump to this. So what the fuck y'all moving on up? Get the group on with this. So hold your pump to this. So what the fuck y'all moving on up? Get the group on with this. So hold your pump to this. So what the fuck y'all moving on up? Yo, check it out like this. Here we go.
Walk in the tunnels of hell, the next level. It's a nutcracker giving hell to the devil. Playing the game, the New York pain makes me wanna bust, but I just maintain. Cause nowadays, I talk to a brother. Always love your mother, cause you never get another. In the streets, busting off shots. Fuck the cops, I got superstar props. Big time dough, money is a thriller. I'm getting more iller than a Zodiac killer. No lie, but before I say bye, you can't take money with you when you die.
I got niggas flipping their wig, chicks grabbing their cunt. As the rhyme they get over, infant they greet me with blunt. One time for your mind before I break these streets. Ain't nothing holding me back. Hip hop tracks, yo son, you know the feeling. Shit will get revealed as the times I get better. And you know I got skills. I seen the days turn into nights as the stars shine bright. Motherfuckers my wetting, chicks they keep stretching like Dawn Prairie Yarn. One day we'll live large, word to Allah, and it don't seem hard. No more jealousy and envy, curses put upon me. Watch me live free as can be. My niggas you see rising to the top like a rocket ship. Yo, I go far.
Superstar.
So what the fuck y'all moving on up? Get the group on with this. So hold your pump to this. So what the fuck y'all moving on up? Get the group on with this. So hold your pump to this. So what the fuck y'all moving on up? Get the group on with this. So hold your pump to this. So what the fuck y'all moving on up? Check it out like this.
Yo, Pete, run that.
So we're back. So we were just talking offline about concerts and great concerts and bad concerts and great performers and bad performers. So let's how should we approach this one?
Best for me is The Roots, which we've said, yeah, for sure.
Okay. I have a few. I'll start off with Dead Prez.
Yeah.
The one time that both Stickman and M1 got to cross the border to perform here, they performed at Grey Hall. Best concert, best show. And I say that because it was so well-rounded where they would stop and talk to the audience and be like, what books are you reading?
Nice.
Look at homeboy and M1 and be like, what do you read? He's like, I'm reading this book and it's about that. And go right back. And then they go right back into music.
Right.
And they'd pause and they'd be like, you know, and we're up on our health too. Like, what? These are fools that you should stay away from because they're this and that. And it was just the most informative. It was like a concert and it was like I was at like a rally at the same time learning shit.
Yeah.
Best hip hop show ever.
Okay.
Dead Prez.
Okay. For me, God, I've been to so many. It was London, 1993, Notorious B.I.G. Yeah.
For real.
He came over and literally he didn't actually have to perform.
Word.
He just start a song, crowd goes up.
Yeah.
Done. And he was stunned.
I can imagine.
So when he was, he had an interview the following year on TV, they said, what's the best concert you've ever done? He said, London.
You mentioned that.
Because I didn't have to perform. They were like,
crazy.
Every single song, every single word is just incredible.
Yeah. I have a concert that was like that actually, but you haven't gone yet. So, actually, no, you did. You said
yeah,
Roots.
Yeah, actually, I have another one from it going way back when I saw Black Sheep live.
Oh yeah.
That
oh,
was yeah. a bananas concert as well.
Oh yeah.
That was off the charts. I'd never seen energy like that, and that's when I was very young and hip hop was the hype for me.
Yeah.
That concert was huge. Those guys were up on the rafters, climbing up the side. This was at Spectrum. You guys know where Spectrum is.
I have no idea, but I'm sure you guys know.
I just aged myself big time, but yeah, it was at this club called Spectrum, and they ripped that place down.
Okay.
It was sick.
What about you, Spec?
I got to throw in Rakim at the Phoenix.
Okay.
This was like, man, 7-8 years ago, man.
Okay.
And he was the first that I'd ever seen go on stage where he didn't have to complete his lyrics. He'd say the first two bars, stop, and let the audience say the rest. He'd say the four bars and let the audience say the other four. Like, he hardly had to perform.
Yeah. I think the one that most influenced me was Public Enemy. Mm. The very first tour of the UK.
Wow.
It was Def Jam tour. It was Eric B. Rakim, Public Enemy, and LL Cool J.
Wow.
That's all you need. That's all you need.
Yeah, it was that.
That was enough.
I ain't gonna lie.
To be like, I want to be a part of this for the rest of my life.
But Leaders was good as well. Leaders of the New School.
Oh, I would love to see that.
They were insane. Buster is
the energy.
The consummate performer.
There's certain people I see old videos and old footage of them performing. I wish I would have seen them back in the day, like Redman and Death Squad. I wish I would have seen them live because they look like it was crazy.
I love Redman live.
I had a very funny story about Redman, but I can't say it on the radio. Shoot. All right. So, you know, we're going to get into a very quick interview with Spec. Let me find your track here.
Hey.
Toronto's finest, Spec One. We're gonna have a little quick interview with him.
Yeah!
Right after this song. This is my favorite song on your album, by the way. Love it.
All the mountains. Jealous of the gates of Zion, more than all the dwellings of Jacob. Glorious things have been spoken of the O city of God. I'll make mention to Rahab and Babylon to them that know I. With the old Philistine Tyria, with Ethiopia, it shall be said that this man was born there. And the highest himself shall establish the earth. Jah Rastafari.
Advocate forever, forever, forever.
I don't open doors, I walk through them. I never climb mountains, I talk to them. I say the magic words to them and they start moving. That's how close Mother Nature is to dark humans. Something in the melanin don't lack up like the rapper Eminem. Haters wish I quit and never represent again, but instead I've been better than I ever been. It took years of coming in sixth place until I finally got my big break. See, as a boy, it's normal to miss the toilet, especially if daddy wasn't around to teach you to piss straight. I'm the Africa that you don't see but will hear, cause my sound is too OB. I'm the second coming of Kumo D. You're just ice with two rows
in. Forever.
Yeah, Spec One in the studio.
Yeah, yeah.
What's going on, my friend?
I'm doing gravy, man. How are you?
I am tired. It's been a long day.
Same here. Likewise, man. It's my last day before I head off
to South Africa. So
South Africa, yeah.
So, you know, we've had you on the station before. In fact, you are our very, very first artist we interviewed when we were in the other place in the basement.
Yep. I feel honored because I remember the basement. You guys have come a long way.
Yes. Yeah, definitely changed since those days. So tell us a little bit about your what you've been up to since you've released your album.
Since I finished my album, I've just pretty much been riding the wave of this album. I didn't anticipate that it was gonna make as much noise as it did, and I didn't anticipate that it would keep getting life over and over the way it did. It's like every 2 months pass and then we hear that we're nominated for this or we've been selected for that and so on and so forth. And it's been such a blessing. It's been seriously humbling because it's been 5 years since I've released a project. And I figured a lot, most of the people would have forgot about me.
Oh, well, never that, my friend. Mm-hmm. And we myself and Speck were introduced to each other when we did the Slack of the Beach Yard show at the Drake.
Yes.
Album launch party. Yeah, it was another amazing experience.
It's an interesting experience.
Yeah,
though.
Yeah. And then we did it again at the Drake with Illa J.
Yes.
Yeah.
Not I love that show.
Yeah. You bodied him, by the way. I'm saying, you know.
I hope so.
No, Speck represented Toronto against a legend, to be honest, you know, and Illa was absolutely over the moon with the whole performance, so it was great.
We spoke afterwards, yeah. Man, we exchanged, like, congratulations, and he was like, I dig this your song, I dig this from your album, we're exchanging that. Keep in contact randomly here and there.
Yeah.
That was a really dope show, yo.
Yeah. It was really
thank
good
y'all.
Show.
Thank y'all for having me. Yeah.
It's all right, my friend. Anyway, so you're off to South Africa. tell us a bit about what you're going to be doing out there in terms of this particular concert or this series of concerts, the 7 dates you got out there.
So me and my brother, DJ Soulchild, had come with the concept for a festival called Ankh Fest, where we pretty much take the festival to wherever you're at and collaborate with the local artists, the artists that are within the community, to make it a situation where painters can come, photographers can come, the local businesses can come and sell whatever they have and whatnot. And just basically putting the logic of group economics behind the concert and the show. So I was introduced to one of the brothers out there in South Africa by Ian Kamau. And he took in my music and he was like, yo, how can we make this happen? How can we bring you here? So we've been in talks back and forth for about 6 months. And fast forward to now, I'll be flying out tomorrow and we'll be doing 5 to 6 different cities within South Africa.
Okay. Yeah. Okay. Absolutely. Yeah, that's amazing. And yeah. We're happy to be one of the sponsors on your tour. We've always been a massive supporter of you.
Absolutely.
You see us. We see you as our artists. So,
in several ways, I am. In several ways, I am. I'm not even gonna front. You know, we've definitely coincided with each other along the way over the past few years. I've seen iLive build, and you've got to see me.
Yeah.
Come out with the music and build. You know, so yeah. Beautiful.
Okay. So, on your trip out there, you're going to be stopping over in the UK, and I know you had the interview with DJ Crocodile from Colourful Radio today.
Yes, sir.
And I know you've been to London before.
I've been to London twice.
Yeah, you've been to London twice, right?
Yeah, so, I love it out there. It's another Toronto.
It is. So, what are you looking forward to most in your stopover into London?
I'm looking forward to taking in the vibe again, man. I don't know, there's a certain vibe in London I really like. I really mess with. I'm looking forward to touching down in Brixton for the first time because we managed to set up a little show situation. So that's going to be a real dope situation for me. And I'm excited to hit up Camden and places like Brick Lane and those places that I haven't seen in a minute, man.
Yeah, yeah. London's great. I mean, I come from there, so, you know, it's cool. So in terms of now you've worked this album. You know, and it's still got life, it's still got legs, and congratulations for the multiple nominations for, you know, Black Body Video with Shy, and, you know, nominations of the album and all this kind of stuff. It's always popping up on Facebook, on my feed, that...
It's, you know, an annoying album still. It keeps coming back.
Man.
It won't like, die. It's a zombie album.
Yeah, it won't go away. But that's a testament to the strength of the album, that people are still taking it in now.
Bless.
You know, without a doubt.
I co-sign that.
Yeah. It is. And, you know, producer Lord Quest, Claremont. Just see him all over the place now.
He is the hungriest right now. And nothing but great things are going to happen for that kid.
Yeah. That's cool. Yeah, so the Toronto scene, generally, you know, who do you think's the next, outside of Claremont, because Claremont's doing his thing, who do you see coming up that you think is going to be the next big thing that's coming out of Toronto? There's a lot of talent here, a lot of stuff going on.
Besides myself?
Besides yourself.
Okay. I'd have to say I really mess with Sidani.
Yeah.
She's really dope. I feel like She's gonna have a lot of really dope things to talk about. I'm waiting on that Shy Wisdom. She's got some stuff brewing, you know. I feel like Tory Lanez, I can't even say he's next. I think he's done it. I think he's there.
Yeah.
You know, I'm really proud of dude. I've never known him personally, but I could remember his humble beginnings. So it's really dope to see where he's at now.
Indeed, indeed.
Daniel Caesar.
Okay.
I haven't heard much of his music, but from what I've heard, there's some quality there, man.
Right.
I really dig it.
Right. One thing I've always said, and one of the reasons why I put you in touch with DJ Crocodile, you know, we're trying to do this collaboration across the waters with various people to start bringing some of these artists, yourself and other artists, over to Europe and expose you, because in the UK we don't know that there's Canadian hip hop. We didn't know Slacker was Canadian. We didn't know Glenn Lewis was Canadian. We didn't know that Cardinal Official was Canadian. What? We didn't know the Dream Warriors was Canadian, because they're not marketed as Canadian artists.
Yeah, that's true.
You know, and I think it's very important that Canadian artists get recognized for the talent they've got. I mean, your country of 33 million people, you shouldn't have this much talent.
Mm-hmm.
You shouldn't.
Mm-hmm.
You shouldn't.
I feel like the training grounds out here are very harsh, and that's what has made Toronto into the powerhouse that it is today.
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, yeah. You know, Drake's put it on the map, but
yeah, man.
That OVO sound is a sound, and that's what people associate Toronto with
Toronto.
Which is it's good and bad, I think. So,
yeah.
You know, it's, you know, if that's what people are looking for coming out of Toronto, if something else sounds different, they're like, okay, that's not, don't really call
it. I only see it as good for this reason, that it leaves way for there to be the counterculture to coexist with it, you know, but that counterculture just needs to have a wave, and it needs to have someone who leads, or a few people who lead that.
You know? Yeah, you need a path.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You need a path. Without a path, you can't reach your destination.
Absolutely.
That's my take on it. Mm-hmm. Anything to add, St. Lucia?
Yeah, I was thinking, Toronto hip-hop scene has always been that way. It's been very rich. We have so many talented artists, mm-hmm. and that's always been the case. But we needed that bubble of, you know, the insulation that we always had. We needed the Drake to sort of open it up. So now
absolutely.
People are looking for that. What's going on in Toronto? If this guy came from here, what else is going on there?
Absolutely.
It was necessary. I think we'll get more of a look internationally now than we do.
And that's
but
what I feel like.
We have to be recognized as Canadians, as you're saying. Like,
yeah.
Those are huge artists, mm-hmm. and people should know where they came from, right?
Absolutely.
Instead of automatically associating them with the States.
Exactly. I think it's you know, in talking to Glenn Lewis when we were doing a concert, you know, a lot of it for him was he looked south of the border for validation.
Right.
Validation comes from within.
Yeah.
Comes from home.
And then you recognized across the border, and you be recognized elsewhere. You fly that Canadian flag high. Don't not fly it high.
Mm-hmm.
So that's one of the things that we're going to strive to do with iLive Radio, and the connections that we have across the water. Start bringing some artists over there and start doing some stuff. All right, man. So I don't want to keep you on the interview. We've got plenty more to talk about. New material. When's the new EP coming? Because I know there's something brewing, my friend.
What I can and will say is that after the success of Black Body, which was the only track on the album that I produced, and ended up being the biggest song on the album, after the success of that, it gave me more confidence to be like, you know what, let me self-produce the whole next project, or as much of it as I can. So I've just been in producer mode right now. I'm
okay.
Like 6 or 7 beats deep right now.
Right.
Yeah, man. So after a few more, I'll start laying down songs, but you can definitely expect a single off of the project before the summer's over.
Okay, well, that's good, man. Make sure you bless iLive Radio with a copy of that.
Absolutely.
Give us the exclusive, my friend.
Gets the exclusive. I want to get what do you mean?
Get him to sign the contract, man.
Debut,
blood.
Yeah. Debut.
Yeah, man.
All right, so you're tuned into Rapsolute. We're doing the top 5. So we talked about concerts. We talked about groups. We've talked about individual rappers. What else? Okay, so going back to the Canada thing and Canadian hip-hop groups.
Mm. Yeah.
Do you know who the most revered hip-hop group is coming out of Canada? Which one do you think it is?
What are you talking about, like,
recognized
of all time?
Classics, yeah. Classic hip-hop groups.
Worldwide? I'd have to say the homie Q and Dream Warriors.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, they're there.
I think Dream Warriors is it.
Yeah.
Other groups had their successes and their things, but I think I feel like it may have been the Dream Warriors. Am I right?
You're right. Yeah, they're the biggest group that's come out of Canada.
By definition, that was a huge song.
Yeah, it was huge everywhere.
Yeah, I didn't know they're Canadian for a good minute. I had no idea.
Yeah. I know, and they were in London, they were in England for ages. We used to see them all over the place. We never knew they were Canadian.
It was like that with Ghetto Concept. I didn't know they were Canadian. Then I found out they're from Rexdale, my neighborhood. Right. I'm like, wow.
I know. We were having that same debate the other day about Main Source.
Ah.
So they had one American rapper, two Canadian DJs. It's considered a Canadian group.
The Rascals too came out.
Yeah, the Rascals came out.
I ran into
Red One.
I ran into them in Manhattan once by chance. I was getting some street meat.
Okay, I won't ask what street meat is. I won't. It sounds it sounds bad already.
It's like a skewer.
Chicken skewer.
Yeah,
it's chicken. Are you sure?
That's what they said.
Yeah. Like
after some documentaries, I'm not sure anymore, but it could have been some cat or something.
So the Rascals came out of BC.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, that's a new one for me. BC. I didn't know that.
I rate the Rascals for when they denied the Juno.
Yeah.
They won it. They said that you guys don't respect us enough and don't back us enough. So this Juno award you're giving us is a farce. Pushed it back to them.
Yeah.
That's a rated.
Okay, so we're gonna go into another top five. Top five classic tracks.
Top five
classic tracks. Not your five. Your fives are done.
Oh yes.
The Message.
The Message.
Grandmaster Flash. Yes. Five. Still to this day, when I bump it, it like is ridiculous.
Okay, it's number one.
Triumph Wu-Tang.
Why Triumph? Why not any other Wu-Tang track?
Because I mean, I was a fan of Wu-Tang from the jump, but when they came with Triumph in that video, I can remember sitting in the living room watching it, and I was like, wow, they just raised the bar again.
Yeah.
So Triumph had that effect on me. A Tribe Called Quest, Electric Relaxation.
Yeah.
That was my introduction to Tribe.
Yeah.
And changed my whole perception of how hip-hop should sound.
Absolutely.
You know, and this young cat by the name of Dilla, who nobody knew about, was in the background just constructing all this. I think I can't go past
you can't
three.
Go, right? You got three.
I can't go past three.
Okay.
That's my three.
That's your three. Okay. St. Lucia.
Wait a minute. He has to go for the five.
Okay, all right. You have to go for the five.
You
can't not do it. Go for your camera right now, bro. Don't let it slide.
Okay.
Represent Rexdale. Do it. Two more.
What was it? We're talking about top five.
Top five classic tracks.
Classic tracks. Let's see. Busta Rhymes. Put Your Hands Where My Eyes Can See.
Okay.
That was a very impactful song and video.
One more.
Nas Made You Look.
Made You Look.
If I was stuck on an island and I had one song I could listen to for the rest of my life, it would be Nas Made You Look.
Okay.
Yes,
that's Specs top five classic tracks. St. Lucia.
Top five classics. Far Side.
Okay. Which one?
Pass Me By.
Mm-hmm.
That one forever. We're gonna sing out. Oh my gosh. That's a lot of pressure.
Mm-hmm.
I would say Nas as well. One Mic.
Okay.
I love that song.
Big song.
If I think of Leaders.
Which one?
Too many.
That's the question, right?
That's which one?
K
to the PTA, Self Story,
Roller Coaster.
Sound of the Zetas was mine.
Yeah. Okay.
Then again, PTA used to make me wild out as well.
PTA was live.
Yeah. I think for me, Black Sheep,
Choice is yours.
Engine number, yeah.
Okay, choice is yours.
That song has special connection. They busted. I had a Sweet 16, and when that song came down, everybody crouched down nice and low.
Hey.
Man, they started punching jewels in the ceiling of my basement. So that song is a classic to me. I think I don't know. I'm stuck at 3-2.
You stuck at 3?
You see what I'm saying?
Oh, these are weak, man.
I'm stuck at 3-2. Pete Rock and CL Smooth. That one, as I was driving, reminisce for sure.
Yeah,
sure.
Is
a classic to me.
Sure is a classic.
One more. MC Light.
Cram to Understand.
Cram to Understand would be the one for me.
Okay, that's good. See,
that
you
was hard.
You all struggled over your top five. I want to go straight in immediately. Right?
Look at the spark.
Look at
his
this. I know, right? So, number one, Rebel Without a Pause, Public Enemy.
Yeah.
Right.
That's one. Two, Chorus Line, Ultra Magnetic MCs.
Okay.
Wow.
Three, Remember This Remember Over You, Pete Rock, CL yeah. Smooth. Number four, interestingly, and don't ask me why, it was Ice Cube, Jacking for Beats. Because
okay.
I love that track, right? And number five for me has to be a Tribe track. Has to be a Tribe track, and it's Lyrics to Go.
Yeah, okay. That's a huge tune.
Lyrics to Go was not number five. So that's my top five, without thinking.
That's all
right. See guys, I went in, right? Just straight.
That was boom. But see, you knew that you were going to ask that, so you.
I know, that's why I was prepared.
Putting people on the spot.
I was prepared. Anyway, you're tuned into Rapsalute. I don't know what's going on there. My thing just went funny. You're tuning to Rapsalute. We're going to get with some more music. Spec One and Lucia in the building. If I can load this damn thing. Okay, there you go. Nope, it's not working. God damn it. There you go. All right. So we're going to get into some more music. Last 25 minutes to go. We're going to do one more top five topic. Massive shouts out to Greg Stokes, who keeps texting everybody, talking about Andre 3000. We'll have a conversation about the worst MCs of all time and put him inside there.
Oh, snap.
No.
I'm joking.
Really?
I'm joking. Anyway, let's get into some gangsta.
And stunts than Bruce Willis, a poet like Langston Hughes, and can't lose when I cruise. out on the expressway. Leaving the bodega, I say suave. Premier's got more beats than Bond's got hate. Clips are inserted into my gun, so I can take the money, never have to run.
My Philly at home, do you have another? I wanna get blunted, my brother. Now may I make a mark, then make a spark over this fat track. What did I say, dope beat? Subtract, delete all of the wick-whack that wanna be abstract, but they lack the new knack that's coming from way, way back. Ayo, Premier, please pass that Buddha sack. You heard we quit? No way, bullshit. I told you before, we come back with more hits. I provide right flavor, so you can sketch me. Do me a favor, don't try to catch me. Slightly ahead of the game, I'm not a lame. Ask him, he'll tell you the same. He knows my name, smooth. I drop jewels like paraphernalia. I'm infallible, not into failure. Like a rhinoceros, my speed is prosperous, and pure knowledge expands from my esophagus.
Once knew a nigga whose real name was William. His primary concern was making a million, being the illest hustler that the world ever seen. He used to fuck movie stars and sniff coke in his dreams. A corrupted young mind at the age of 13. Nigga never had a father and his mom was a fiend. She put the pipe down, but for every year she was sober. Her son's heart simultaneously grew colder. He started hanging out, selling bags in the projects, checking the young chicks, looking for hit and run prospects. He was fascinated by material objects, but he understood money never bought respect. He built a reputation cause he could hustle and steal, but got locked once and didn't hesitate to squeal. So criminals he chilled with didn't think he was real. You see, me and niggas like this have never been equal. I don't project my insecurities on other people. He fiended for props like addicts with pipes and needles, and so he felt he had to prove to everyone he was evil. A feeble-minded young man with infinite potential, the product of a ghetto-bred capitalistic mental. Coincidentally, dropped out of school to sell weed, dancing with the devil smoked until his eyes would bleed. But he was sick of selling trees and gave in to his greed. Everyone trying to be trife never faced the consequences. You probably only did a month for minor offenses. Ask a nigga doing life if he had another chance. But then again, there's always the wicked that knew in advance. Dance forever with the devil on a cold cell block. But that's what happens when you rape, murder, and sell rock. Devils used to be gods, angels that fell from the top. There's no diversity because we're burning in the melting pot. So Billy started robbing niggas anything he could do. Get his respect back in the eyes of his crew. Starting fights over little shit up on the block. Stepped up to selling mothers and brothers the crack rock. Working overtime, making money and overtime. Making money and overtime. Making money and overtime. Making money.
Here comes the pitch. And it comes in wide. And the count now is 1-1 to Jackie Robinson. Billy Martin.
Yo, you better salute because it is rap salute. You hear me? John Bronski right here, I Love Radio.
It might be a homicide, so let the drama slide. We don't want no problems, B.
So we're just here debating battle rappers. Who's that guy that you'll go to war with at any given time when it comes to freestyle or battle raps? So I think the unanimous decision was is Eminem, right?
Yes.
But I have to go with him.
You gotta go with him.
All right. He's just sharp, witty, swift.
Okay. Well, I was going with Cannabis. When Cannabis was good. I know about the choking thing. I know.
But he can't be of all time if that's the legacy that he's left behind.
So
he had a moment when he could have bodied some folks, but in his current
5 years. He had 5 or 6 years where he was just like...
Exactly. You
know, I'll say this, that if M and Cannabis ever had like a proper battle, it could have went either way.
Yeah.
I feel like it could have went either way.
Yeah. Now, like I said to you, the YouTube thing where they were on the same radio station going verse for verse, and Cannabis dropped this verse that he never dropped since. Yeah. And it's like he was waiting for that moment with M and it's like, boom. And M... had no answer for him.
For real.
But you know who else is like that as well? Royce da 5'9".
Yes.
Royce is sick.
Royce is crazy.
Yeah, Royce
that's
is crazy.
Very true. I had the opportunity to follow him for a day with some cameras and such. And intermittently through the day, he would just start to spit. It was sick.
Real.
Absolutely ridiculous. Yeah, he's the beast.
Yeah, wicked. So right underneath here, we've got Crooklyn Dodgers, Crooklyn, absolute classic, Posse Tracks.
Yeah.
Hey.
All right. So
I like the other version, to be honest.
You really like Crooklyn Dodgers too?
Yeah. That's
with Chubb Rock.
I love both, but that one's a better one in my opinion.
Better than Master Ace, Special like Ed, and yeah.
Ooh, Special Ed's another one.
Five Rock. Men and a Mic.
Yeah.
Five Men and a Mic. Yeah.
Special Ed's another one.
So Posse Tracks.
Posse Tracks.
Posse Tracks. Just name one.
Mystery of Chess Boxing.
Yeah?
Yep.
Wu-Tang.
Absolutely.
See, the Wu-Tang Clan for me, I don't know.
Wu-Tang is forever.
Oh, that's what they say, right? Okay, so, talking about Wu-Tang, who is do you think is the top MC out of Wu-Tang?
Meth.
Meth?
Yeah. I had my different times. Like, I was balancing between Meth and Inspector Deck. Inspector Deck influenced the way I used to write lyrics.
Right.
Heavily, because he used to have, like, the repeated two-bar rhyme scheme. I thought that was crazy.
Okay.
I'd have to give it to Meth overall. His rhyme scheme was just way more intricate.
Yeah. Okay. And
I would agree. Meth? I would agree, Meth as well.
Over Ghost? Over Raekwon?
Yes.
Now, Ghost has the better albums than all members.
Uh-huh.
He has better projects and bodies of work than all members, but in terms of, like, MC and Meth when he was Meth.
Yeah.
Was like the best out of all of them.
Okay.
Yeah. Wordplay, musicality over the beats, flowed deep, like he wrote a beat and you were grooving not only to the beat but the way he was flowing as well.
Right.
There was something to just grab you and sort of ride you with.
He had that personality above everybody else.
Yeah.
I'll give you that. He had the star quality. Yeah. He was a superstar. Next to him and ODB were the superstars.
Yes.
Absolutely.
The one I couldn't abide, no offense, was the GZA.
Really?
The GZA used to drive me nuts. Look, and I say this because...
I get it.
I say this because the GZA himself was... The first time I heard GZA actually do something...
He was the genius.
He was the genius.
Yeah.
And the first thing I heard him was on a new Jack Swing track.
Yep.
So from since then, I couldn't never really take him seriously.
And with the RZA when he was Raheem, Prince Raheem.
Prince Raheem. Swinging. Prince Raheem. Yeah. So I couldn't really take him seriously.
That was it for
you. All right, so... You say Mystery of Chess Horse Boxing, Posse Track.
Scenario.
Scenario?
Yeah.
There you go. To me, that's an ultimate Posse Track. Yeah. Scenario.
That's awesome Posse Track.
Yeah.
That is. It builds.
Yeah.
The gold standard.
And every time you think of it, you think about you and your posse, everyone's...
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Well, it's the whole... Everything rides up to the Busta Rhymes verse.
Absolutely.
Everything rides up to the Busta Rhymes verse. It's like, you go to a party. I went to Insomnia once, and DJ started from scratch. Fantastic DJ. Played
Amnesia.
Scenario. Amnesia, that's it.
Insomnia.
I had Insomnia by the end of that party. I mean, you know that now, all right? Because I was like... Yeah, I couldn't go to sleep with the coolness I heard, but Amnesia, and he was winding up Scenario, and he didn't get to the Busta part.
That's criminal.
It's like, cut it in. I don't know. I don't understand. Okay.
That's criminal.
All right. So we've got 10 minutes left. So we always talk about hip-hop and those tracks that don't get much shine. What's your favorite track that didn't get a lot of airplay, but you love to hear it?
Have mercy, these questions.
Sorry, am I asking too difficult a question here?
Yeah.
We're all hip hop.
Ask Spec first.
Okay, Spec. That one track that
I see how it's gonna be.
Yeah.
That's kind of difficult as well, because when you sit and think about it, it's like radio play here is different from elsewhere. So,
well, you don't want radio play ones, right?
The song that didn't get radio play.
Yeah, the one that you like, this should have been on the radio but didn't quite get there. That one track, like no one's feeling that track really in the radio. And
probably by one of the most underrated MCs, AZ.
Yeah.
and is I think the song is called Love Tonight or something, and it's on like that Pieces of a Black Man album.
Right.
And it was hella commercial.
Yeah.
And it was hella, like, if you break down his rhyme scheme in it, it was best of both worlds. And for me, I feel like that should have been a crossover song for him, and he just didn't quite get there.
All right. What about you, St. Lucia? You got your paper there.
I know. All your things written down. Your underrateds. I have The Format by AZ.
Another AZ track.
Yeah, that's one for me. I think that should have. Do you have it?
No.
I think honestly, when you really think of AZ as an artist altogether, he should have done so much more or gone so much further than he did. He was like a hidden gem, start to finish.
Absolutely.
I concur. For myself, there was a super group that was put together by DJ Spinner.
Another posse cut. That's
this is a crazy posse crowd.
This is Nas' breakthrough right here.
That's right. Fatal, Nas, Large Professor, Akineli.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. There was a little super group that DJ Spinner put together called the Polyrhythmatics, and Pharaoh Monk was in it after he left
Organized Confusion.
They did a track called Reach It, which was like...
Yes.
Yeah, you know the track?
Yep.
Yeah.
I think he's underrated as well.
Absolutely.
In a major way.
Way. He's the guy who every like 5-7 years he'll drop an anthem.
Yes.
Yeah.
Because remember the time between Organized Confusion and Simon Says was a long time, but he just came back like he never left.
Yeah.
He's actually a good friend of mine. The thought process that works behind those songs, it's like a mad scientist.
Right.
Crazy. Mad scientist. He's incredible.
Okay.
Crazy.
Really creative individual.
Okay. So honorable mentions for this particular show. Outkast, honorable mention.
Definitely. Absolutely.
As much as I hate to say it, Outkast, honorable mention. Run DMC.
Without a doubt.
Best
honorable
group.
Mention. Best group.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Honorable mention. Any others that we haven't really picked up on that should get an honorable mention right now? Jay-Z, I guess, honorable mention.
House of Pain.
Yeah?
I like them at times.
I want to squint at you right now.
Okay, I'll take it back.
Yeah, take that one back.
I did.
Take that one back.
I like them at times. this fella.
This guy.
Honorable mention for greatest. I mean, there's so many. If you were to go back to like the KRS era, like I really want to say Slick Rick.
Yep. Mr. Brixton.
Especially live performance wise.
Yeah.
Man.
Honorable mention Slick Rick.
Absolutely.
Yeah, for sure. Okay. Slick Rick live is a good show as well.
Mm-hmm. Honorable mention De La Soul.
More than an honorable mention.
There you go.
For De La Soul.
And it's interesting when you talk about hip hop, no one really ever mentions De La.
Yeah, more. They're majorly underrated. And those fellas are sick with it.
Yeah.
Honorable mention Onyx.
Onyx.
Yeah.
Onyx.
Okay.
See, and look at the time frame that all that's coming from, right?
Yeah. The golden era.
Yeah.
The golden era of hip hop.
All a particular time.
So no one from the 2000s. From the millennium.
No.
I'll put TDE in there.
Yeah.
Those boys are crazy.
Okay.
Kendrick, Schoolboy, J Rock. Crazy.
Yeah.
other groups they got out there.
Yeah, Del the Funky Homo Sapien.
Del.
Yep, Del for sure.
Iron Griffin's crew.
That whole Jungle Brothers and.
That was more Artifacts.
Okay.
Artifacts, I like them as well.
Okay.
No, that was Artifacts.
From the wrong side of the tracks.
I'm thinking of my dude. I actually met him before. He's a real cool dude, Elder Sensei.
Yeah.
From Artifacts, Jersey. Okay. Jersey man.
Okay. No Slum.
Slum, absolutely.
Slum for sure.
Yeah. Slum for sure.
Yeah. Underrated.
As well, Black Eyed Peas before
Before the commercials.
Before they went commercial.
Yeah.
And that's what people don't understand. Black Eyed Peas' first LP was...
They were back records.
Yeah.
Wicked.
You talk about Falling Out? That whole transition.
Man. Yeah, man.
Yeah, they were sick.
Well, I understand why they transitioned across. It's money, right? So, but you know, what's his name does underground hip-hop stuff all the time.
Will.i.am?
Yeah, Will.i.am.
Yeah.
Does it all the time. So we've got, 5 minutes? Mm-hmm. Any last thoughts or messages or things you would like to say before we sign off for the night?
I'd like to say that we have left so much uncovered.
Oh, yeah.
Tonight.
We have to do it again.
Like, this is totally just scratching behind the ears.
We have to do it again with Stokes.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yes.
Because all he's going to come in there and say is, where's Andre 3000 call out? Right. I mean, do you guys rate Andre 3000?
Absolutely.
I do, yeah, for sure.
Hell yeah.
Okay.
For sure.
Hell yeah.
And Big Boy, to be honest.
The group.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Together, the dynamic between them is something special, I think.
They balance.
Okay.
It balances very well.
Okay. Yeah. It's not. I don't know. Maybe it's just me. I'm not really a massive Andre 3000 fan. I do like their stuff. I think it's very, very clever, but not a massive, massive Andre 3000 fan.
Hip hop is the longest lasting, longest surviving form of black music right now when you think about it.
Yeah.
Because everything else that we've like pioneered and trailblazed eventually fizzled out and turned into something else, whereas hip-hop is like the longest. So it's a beautiful thing that we have to go through eras when we're choosing top fives and everything. It's not that easy to do anymore.
No.
Yeah.
No.
That was the exact thing I was saying. Like, it's so hard when I think about it. Like, hip-hop was so many different things at different points in my life, right?
Okay.
So now I don't know what's going on. But
that's a whole different discussion. Yeah.
Yeah. Honorable mention as well for Lauryn Hill and Souls of Mischief.
Souls of Mischief. I'll give you that one.
Yeah.
I can't give you Lauryn Hill
now.
I can't.
No Lauryn Hill?
I can't do Lauryn Hill now.
Why?
You sound like you had a bad experience.
Oh, yes. Yeah. Yeah. Because of that. Tell you like the cannabis thing when he choked. Lauryn Hill and 15 hours to get on stage and a non...
15 hours?
it's way exaggerated. 2 hours.
All right.
2.5 hours late on stage and nondescript kind of... You know, blasé kind of performances.
Oh,
you know, it's not really conducive to me, really. But she was a beast back in the day.
She went through a phase where she was.
She was like hardcore
diva stuff.
As a performer, I feel it for performers when I see that happen or hear that happens.
Yeah.
Because as a performer, I feel like every time you're getting ready to go out on stage, you're always thinking of the possibility of that happening.
That's right.
Because it can happen at any time. Where you just go.
Yep. Like, you know. Yep. You can all go. Pete Tong, as we say in England. Mm-hmm. Go wrong. All right, so we'll play one more track when we get out of here. Thank you very much, guys, for coming in. We'll have to do this again.
Absolutely.
So, big shout out to Miss St. Lucia.
Thank you.
And to Spec One.
Bless
Good luck in the UK and over in South Africa.
Thank you.
Make sure you send plenty of pictures back and all that kind of thing. I'll bring back some South African rum for me.
Absolutely.
This has been Rapsalute. My name's DJ Sessions. I'll be back on the radio Sunday for Father's Day. I'm actually doing a show with my dad.
Aww.
That should be fun. No, it's not. It's not. Don't do that. Don't do that. He thinks he's a DJ. This is hilarious. Nice. Anyway, we're going to play last track here, coming from a brand new album from De La Soul, which is going to be absolutely phenomenal.
Nice.
This is them featuring Snoop Dogg, and this is Pain. Good night. God bless. This has been Rapsalute.